My name is Margot Lee Shetterly. I'm the author of the book Hidden Figures, which tells a story, true story, this is not fiction, of the African-American women who worked as mathematicians, starting in World War II and going through the space race. One of the women, in fact, the very first woman whose story I tell in the book is Dorothy Johnson Vaughan, who in addition to being an amazing mathematician, had the distinction of being the very first black supervisor in the organization that became NASA. She was the head of the segregated West Computers Unit. She supervised a group, a room full of black female mathematicians, also brilliant women. And she nurtured the careers of so many people, including two of the other women that I write about in the book, Mary Jackson and Katherine Johnson, who is very well known for having calculated trajectories for the Mercury astronauts, and who last year received the Presidential Medal of Freedom. So while Mrs. Johnson's name has been known for some decades, Mrs. Vaughan's name was lost to history, and so finding her and finding about her has been one of the great privileges of my life. But one of the things that I had to realize is that a book and a movie are different vehicles, you know, and the kind of thing that people want out of a book and what they want out of 2 hours in a movie are very different. And so I didn't write the screenplay, but the screenwriters made what I thought was a good decision, which is they cannot tell 30 years of history and keep people interested in the movie. So they made the decision to focus on the iconic moment with Mrs. Johnson, where John Glenn is getting ready to go up into space, this orbital flight, which is a transformative moment in the Cold War between the U.S. and the Soviet Union. And he says, get the girl to do it, you know, get the girl, which is what they called all of the women, not just the black women, all of the women were girls, they were computers, get the girl to check the numbers. And that's one of, you know, as one of his pre-flight checklists, if she says they're good, I'm good to go. That was Mrs. Johnson's big moment. It's, you know, it's a very exciting moment. It's a very cinematic moment. So, you know, I totally understand the decision to make that focus. I just hope that people will read the book because there are so many things that show the entire progression, you know, from these first women. So your grandmother showed up in December of 1943, and there were actually, you know, as best I can tell, about 15, 16 other women who were there. You know, the first women came that year, 1943, and they were really the ones who broke the ceiling for the other ones to follow. So, and then the end of the book, I focus on the story of Christine Johnson. She's the one who got to the top. She stood on all the shoulders of the women who came before, and she lived up to their promise and to her promise. So I am so excited about the movie because, you know, it means that this story is never going back into the shadows. But I hope people will read the book to get the fullness of all of these women. And you know, one of the, I love your grandmother, what she stood for, what she did for all of these women, and what she has given to me, even though I never met her.
Equilateral, isosceles, tetrahedron.
I have never seen a mind like the one your daughter has. You have to see what she becomes.
Come on! Uh-huh. Move like that.
Catherine, we all gonna end up unemployed riding around in this pile of junk.
You're welcome to walk the 16 miles.
Or sit in the back of the bus.
Kiss me up!
You have identification on?
We're just on our way to work at NASA, sir.
I had no idea they hired.
There are quite a few women working in the space program.
You know what we're doing here? We're putting a human on top of a missile, shooting him into space that's never been done before.
I need a mathematician that can look beyond the numbers. Math that doesn't yet exist.
You have someone? Running what I'm
playing. Catherine's the gal for that. She can handle any numbers you put in front of her.
We are a computer at NASA. They let women handle that sort of...
Oh, left and left,
Yes, they let women do some things at NASA, Mr. Johnson.
And it's not because we wear skirts.
It's because we wear glasses.
You've been gone for 300 hours.
Was Mama gone for 12 and a half days?
No, but it felt like it.
In 14 days, astronauts will be here for training. Everything we do can matter to their wives, to their children. I believe it's going to matter to the whole country.
My gals are ready.
There's no protocol for women attending.
There's no protocol for a man circling the Earth either, sir.
We all get there together, we don't get there at all. Let me ask you, if you were a white male, would you wish to be an engineer?
I wouldn't have to. I'd already be one.
Don't you know that we're able?